It's on my freaking head!
Oh, come on now, it is!
Give me glove. Yeah, alright, top right there, center compartment.
We got a ways.
We gonna be backing?
This is on the Slug-O-Mar. Yeah, maybe. I'm back to the mono.
Alright, so one might have to undo your safety clip to get you over here. That's what he's going to do.
Phil, pass me that box, pass me that bag. Okay, let's see out of here.
Okay, I'm going to...
Yep, that's all right.
Let's just keep the line caught.
Alright, what time we got?
We got
tuna time. Somewhere is my set of gloves, my orange gloves, so I can thumb this line.
Where are you?
Are they up? I don't know, are they up by the side? Just want to keep a nice bend in that line.
This is a better fish. Yeah, I don't think we can stick him.
We're going to stick him. Bells, can you loosen, or Dave, can you loosen up these sides a little bit so I can get a little more?
There you go, just sit back on. We got all day, don't rush it.
Nice, and you saw him crash it too.
Yes! Yeah, you know what? The rigger clip did go. This is on the black, right? You got the white Slug-O-Mar in.
Is that good? One more? More?
No, that's...
What's that?
That's... No, I guess that's fine. Oh, yeah, he's head shaking. I am gaining on him.
I'm going to constantly keep this thing off the corner of the boat right here, just so you know, right? You don't have to say anything, I'm going to get right on there.
Okay.
And then, as we get to the end game here, I will autopilot and,
We do need a safety line on this. Just to be safe. So, Dave, let's see. So thinking back to that seminar we did, right? They said the fish can do this all day long, right? The fish can. He's just swimming along, right? And what we got to do is put some.
Yeah, just pumping real. Oh, sweet Marie, bring it home, baby.
that makes the trip worthwhile. And so, Bells, where's the best place for me to stand? You want me right up here, or do you want me back there and you're
right
standing?
Right there, right where you are. I'm right here, and Dave's right in front of me. And I'm going to grab the leader, and I'm going to step back. You just make sure you take a little bit off the drag once I got the leader. In case I got to let go of it.
Now, should I be lightening up
where's
the...
maybe a teeny bit.
Where's that? Where's your...
This guy's tight next to us. What's that, Dave?
White boat to our stern. We are tight. White boat to our stern out 5,000 cc. We are tight. Roger.
Yeah, there are two white boats to our stern. To you guys, I'm definitely gaining. Yeah, I'm consistently gaining.
As soon as we see the first knot, we got the first knot on the reel, right?
Yes. Yeah, the next knot is the leader. He's head shaking.
Hey, Dave, after you hit him with a harpoon, just don't look at anything. Just immediately hand that gaff to me, just in case. We got
leader.
We got color. Come on. Right. Grab that harpoon. Come on. Start walking back.
Yeah, baby! Drilled him.
Apparently my adrenaline was pumped a little bit.
So
why don't we
let's get the knife right away just to bleed him before he dies.
Right, well let's bleed him. Then
tail rope him and
tail rope him in the water.
Alright, so you say clean up the ankle line, you mean the...
Oh, that's right. What I meant was
the harpoon.
Yes.
Woo!
I'm not sure it's supposed to fall all the way through the
fish. Thank you, OSHA.
Thank you, Lord!
Right.
Don't want a guy grab here or nothing. Yeah.
Let me have that line. Can you uncleat that for a second?
Alright, you want to kick us into gear? What's he, like 45, 50?
Nah,
45?
No, this guy's, this guy is, 50, 55.
Well, Bells, that last fish guy is 54 and a half inches. He's bigger.
Yeah, it is. He's 100 pounds. I'll pull him in. I'm gonna...
You think? I'd let him just keep cooling. Just what he's doing. You want to cut him some more?
It's gonna break the other
hole. Here, can you undo that clip?
Black.
Woo! All
right.
Yeah. Alright, Bell, I guess grab onto my shorts or something. Yeah, he does. Alright, you want to rake the other gills? Here's the knife. Careful. From all right, do we want to cut them open and clean them?
Well,
cut
the bells actually yank the stomach out from through the gill plate.
Okay,
without opening the belly up.
So Eric would cut the anus and put the hose in.
Yeah.
Tape measure?
Yeah.
Big enough?
Okay, to the end of the fork, right? 56.
Is it to the center?
58, maybe.
No.
It's
here,
to the end of the
right?
fork?
Is that right?
I don't know.
Yeah, to the end of the fork, maybe. 56.
Thinking that you got a 57.
Awesome.
Did it go all the way through?
No, it did not go all the way through.
Yeah, you won't. Oh, no. Yeah.
Nope. Nope. We still have a picture side. Alright, should we set the spread back up?
No. 7 inches?
You want to tell him David hit on a black, and it was the starboard long. It's perfect. Been eating sand eels.
What it looks like, you
So, Bells, how many of these have you caught?
Countless.
Whoa, look at that!
What?
Look at the sand eels coming out. Dave, look at that.
Holy cow.
Just huge, huge sand eels.
Is that a snag right there, Bill?
Yeah. This is just loaded with sand eels here. And water.
That's coming from me. Foot lower.
No, be careful, man. They're nice and crazy sharp.
Do you have your fillet glove? There you go. Nice. You head, Dave, are you heading this home?
Yeah. Look at that, this guy's spread.
fish ice.
Yep. Look at the size of that sand eel. Did you get the heart out? Dave, did you mark where we hit him?
No.
Or mark where we are right now?
Yeah.
Hang on, Bill. All right, you got. You want to grab him by the mouth?
Well, I want to stuff his belly first.
Yep.
And then stuff a whole bag. Oh yeah, if you can do that, that would be great.
The smell of tuna.
Good pieces in there. Bonita.
Whoosh.
Yeah, we can get more.
Hang on, you still got, you got the air bladder. Hang on, let me have the, got the air bladder right there. I got plenty more room for plenty more. I can probably take the whole bag. More?
You want to just do the bag, a little bit of the bag, or you want another solid piece?
Well, you never accused me of being wrong. You were just kind of like, really? No, I got more up here also. We can get that,
Get a bag underneath them.
Dave, have you said your thank you prayer yet?
In fact, I did. Let it drop down on the deck and cross it up a little bit.
Holly, if you can lift this tail, I just want to get a whole layer underneath it.
Okay. Go for it. Right back here. Yeah.
We just place it.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, right there.
Yeah,
now, let's see. I'd love a some sort of a line.
I got the same thing. This is actually almost like...
Yeah, zipper him up.
So why don't we do this? Let's put the rods
back and place them.
Let's put the rods in these holders, and we'll tie to the rods, and we'll kind of lace it up.
Yeah.
Harpoon strength.
No, because it's tied off. Let's hold this for 1 minute. Let me check and see if I have a lighter gauge line.
Here.
You know, we could use some mono. We could use that 200 mono.
Might be hard to
cinch
it up, though.
You don't know how to hold it.
Okay.
Hang on. What about one of those safety straps?
Perfect.
Exactly what we do.
Yeah, baby! That was awesome! Thank you, God!
Yes. That was quite a deal right there. Quite a deal.
Tie it up in a nice, neat little bow. Yeah. You got that one? Is there one more bag of ice, or is this the last one? I think we're good. Can I have another? You got one there. And I need one more something or other.
What happened to just get
how about the, how about your safety cord? Yeah, we arrive and 5 minutes later we go off!
Well, and, you know, we brought three fish in the boat and put three fish in the boat. That's great.
That's called a hat trick. Bells, very nicely done. The whole end game worked.
There's just good fish shit all over my boat here, for God's sake. Flinging guts everywhere. Feel free to do it anytime.
Eight-minute fight. Seem longer than that.
That's gonna be some high quality meat. We didn't cook that meat at all.
Yeah, no, he came right in and... So it's interesting, that dart, if he had, you know, if we had snapped the line,
yeah,
that dart would have pulled. So, well, so, you know, now that we're not all full of adrenaline, right, we can say, well, then we should have been a little more patient and got him in the gill plate. But
is that the preferred, is to shoot right through the gill plate?
I think so. Right, the headshot of the gill plate.
Okay. I had the opportunity. I didn't do it because I thought it'd be too hard to push through.
Maybe on a monster. I don't know.
I hit where I was aiming, and I should.
Yeah,
I didn't aim.
I'm surprised that it didn't go all the way through. Did you poke him or did you? Was it a jab or did you like follow through?
I think I punched it to the point where I felt like it was done, and that was about it. I didn't think any further than that.
I'll take care of that if you get the bags.
The bags?
From downstairs to put the bars in.
Oh, sure.
You don't want to get that in the back of your calf. All right, say goodbye to Mr. GoPro.